Hello, this is an I Am Kitty Hollywood. This week you get a two for the price of one deal. This is because of the Glen Miller Band. They are pretty much the most beloved big band of all time. And in the early 40s, they were so big that somebody said, you know, you guys ought to make movies. So they did. They signed with 20th Century Fox to make two films with the option to make two more. In 1941, they made Sun Valley Serenade. And in 1942, they made Orchestra Wives. Shortly afterwards, Glen Miller was drafted for the army. More on that later. Sun Valley Serenade was conceived of by producer Daryl Zanuck. He had a star under contract, a Norwegian Olympic figure skater by the name of Sonja Henie. She was a huge star. In fact, at one stage, she was one of the highest paid actresses in Hollywood. He had recently visited the skiing mecca of Sun Valley, Idaho, and thought, somebody should make a film here. He signed on director H. Bruce Humberstone, and he gave the job of concocting a story and a screenplay to Art Arthur, Robert Harari, Robert Ellis, and Helen Logan. One gets the impression they gave up halfway through, but the story doesn't matter, not one little bit. What matters is the band, the music. They are great. You watch each musical sequence filmed for Sun Valley Serenade and you are enthralled by the music. Glen Miller, look, he's a pretty good actor. He's not trying to be anyone other than himself, which is probably what makes all the difference with this.
I always figured they were kind of hazel.
Oh, get her off your mind, will you? He's been dreaming about her for days.
It's the kind of girls I dream about, but you should see the kind I get.
When I was 15 years old, when I saw Sun Valley Serenade for the first time, I went out to Ava and Susan's record store in the Town Hall Arcade, and I bought this. I was a convert immediately just from watching Sun Valley Serenade, and it's not that good a film. Look, one of the things that makes up for the dog's breakfast that Sonja Henie makes of the acting is the footage, the skiing and the footage of Sun Valley, contemporary to the time. Look, if you like your skiing movies with a watch a James Bond film, but otherwise this is the way to go. An early Milton Berle is in this film. He's clearly honing his shtick and he's terrific. The sequences of the music playing are surprisingly good. It can't be that easy to direct musicians standing still. He does a good job. Another really good sequence is the black ice skating sequence at the end of the film, and it's visually quite splendid. I think it took 3 days to shoot and it was a hell of a thing. The film was a big deal at the time. John Payne is the pin-up male idol of the film. He's got a lovely voice. Lynn Barry plays the other woman. That was kind of what she did at 20th Century Fox. Which leads me on to orchestra-wise. The thing that distinguishes Glen Miller's films from other films that just happen to have big bands in them is that his band is woven into the plot. It's integral. And in orchestra-wise, he didn't even have an ice skater contend with. So it's all about the band. George Montgomery, Cesar Romero, and a young Jackie Gleason are in the band, a trumpeter, pianist, and bass player. Lynn Barry plays the other woman again. Her voice is dubbed by Pat Friday in both of the films. The crazy thing is that Lynn Barry was 23 when she made this film and George Montgomery was 25. I could have sworn that they were both in their 30s, but I am perhaps age blind. Anne Rutherford is a huge groupie of the Jean Morrison band. She marries George Montgomery, the trumpeter, and has to very quickly come to terms with life as a travelling musician's wife, and in particular with the catty, catty wives who are also on tour. Dale Evans is also in this film before she teamed up with Roy Rogers, and Harry Morgan, who is best known for playing Colonel Sherman T. Potter from MASH, is in this film, and he's fascinating to watch. There's quite a bit of sexual chemistry between Rutherford and Montgomery, which is great and an enormous relief given the complete lack of chemistry between John Payne and Sonia Heaney, to be frank.
Now listen, cutie pie. I'm a big bad trumpet player, and never in my life have I seen anything so gorgeous coming off a dance floor. I've seen thousands. I've kissed some of them. But not like I'm going to kiss you.
Now please.
Do you carry a battery?
What?
Something made my heels tingle. I don't like this engine. I think he's looking for that girl with Bill.
I think he's gonna find her.
The script is quite witty and snappy in spots. It's really enjoyable to watch, but again, you're watching the music scenes. The scenes where the band plays for the kids who put their nickels in the jukebox. It must have been incredible to have been an extra in those scenes, seriously. And there are two other performers I must mention who are in both of the films. They are Harold and Fayard Nicholas, the Nicholas brothers, who were a very famous and well-established musical act. They had a style of dance called flash dancing, and they take your breath away. They filmed the Chattanooga Choo Choo with Dorothy Dandridge in Sunbelly Serenade, and I've Got a Gal in Kalamazoo in Orchestra Wives, and they're electrifying. Once he was in the army, Glenn Miller set about revitalizing the Army Air Force band. They had an extensive touring schedule and really raised the morale enormously of a number of the troops. They were based in England for a while and they were going to take a tour of mainland Europe. Glenn Miller, on December 15, 1944, got on a plane to go to Paris ahead of the band, and the plane was never seen again. So, watch these films. Watch Sunbelly Serenade and Orchestra Wives. For Glenn Miller, for his band, it's worth it.